Of the week again, it's time for the only segment in the boxing world that gives you facts and laughs. It's Clapback Thursdays, motherfuckers! But this week it's coming on a Friday because I'm on vacation and I make the rules. The boxing news is still lame as hell this week, but there are a few topics I want to address. Okay, Floyd Mayweather fought another exhibition against Gotti last Saturday. A real shit show that left the crowd booing in the arena at the end. But in the middle of the second round, Floyd literally had the referee swapped out. He didn't like that the referee told him to stop hitting behind the head. Floyd is used to having the refs do whatever he wants, and he wasn't getting his way this time. It was so embarrassing. Floyd, you're 50 years old. You're a legend in the sport. I've stood up for you in countless interviews, including Shannon Sharpe's podcast last week. But you have to stop embarrassing yourself with these exhibitions. I know life is hard. I know life is expensive. But come on, dude. Put your legacy first. Nobody wants to remember you like this. And it gets worse. Your jeweler filed a lawsuit against you in Miami. And many are saying you're going to have to sell off your assets. I hate seeing this happen, bro. As I've always said, it's hard to make money, but it's even harder to keep it. Floyd, I'm rooting for you. Come on, let's turn it around. And speaking of these horrible exhibition matches, I am so fucking happy to hear and see that their popularity has finally played out. Nobody wants to see these random YouTubers fight each other anymore. I would rather walk outside my house and watch two bums fight in the park for free. It's the same amount of entertainment. My man Turki Alashik is making sure that real boxing is on its way back. And he's standing on making the best fights happen, which is why Canelo doesn't like him, because he's demanding everybody to fight the very best. Which brings me to Canelo. I have two words for you. Archie Solis, remember him? He will be the next topic of Clapback Thursdays next week. Canelo, fuck you.
That's, of course, Oscar De La Hoya, the Golden Boy, with his Clapback Thursday, saying that Mayweather always got what he wanted from the refs, and Mayweather threw the ref out of the ring in his exhibition with John Gotti in the second round. But I didn't know if it was part of the show, or was it authentic, organic. In any event, Oscar also gives Canelo the middle finger, and he spoke about Turki Alshik putting on big fights, and the YouTube boxing is kind of fading out. That's what Oscar is saying. Now, speaking of big cards in Saudi Arabia, I'm getting a lot of indications that Golden Boy are going to do a big card in Saudi Arabia in November. It's going to include Zurdo and Opataya for unification. That's what I'm reading, but it may be another opponent. I'm hearing Jose Ramirez will be in the card. He's going to be fighting Arnold Barbosa. Zepeda, I'm hearing, might be fighting, in my opinion, the weakest champion in the history of boxing, George Kambosos. I think Zepeda demolishes Kambosos, not even close. Loma stopped Kambosos. Stopped him. Lomachenko is not known as a big puncher. He makes people quit because he frustrates them. Or besides, before that, I think Loma did not have a knockout in a minute. And then Devin Haney, who you saw how Ryan Garcia at 10% just destroyed him and exposed everything that I ever said about Haney was exposed in a Ryan Garcia fight. The overhype, the lack of power, the board, the running, the lack of boxing skills, the lack of boxing IQ, all the stuff that everybody said, oh, Haney's the greatest, Haney's the greatest. Where was that greatest? Kept getting hit by a wobbly Ryan Garcia that said that he had a beer before the fight, that he had shots before the fight. And I know people who verified that they saw Ryan with the beer. And Haney was kept getting hit with the same punch. Same punch. You don't see Mayweather getting hit. Mosley hit Mayweather once, and that was it. Mayweather won every other second of that fight from round two on. Great ones don't get hit by the same thing time and time again. That's the way it works. If you're real great. Now, if you're a hype machine, if you're just someone that the media created and gave you nice buzz because you're friendly, because there's other benefits that come with it, great. That, you know, hey, go make your money. Congratulations. But don't say you made $50 million when Eddie Hearn just revealed that he told you before that the money for the fight won't be. You guys are not going to do Tank and Ryan numbers. And I know people sometimes don't understand when I tell them Gervonta Davis is the man. Gervonta Davis is the pound-for-pound king. Gervonta Davis has 12 sellouts in a row. Gervonta Davis and Ryan Garcia, 1.3 million pay-per-view buys, and everyone said it was all Ryan Garcia. I'm sorry to tell you guys. Ryan Garcia and Haney What did they do, 100,000 pay-per-view buys? No, Gervonta is the draw. And if you attach another big name like Ryan, it's going to do even better. But Haney is not Gervonta. He doesn't have the style, doesn't have the fans, doesn't have personality. He may have the media. He may have the people inboxing to back him, but that doesn't represent the millions of fans. Those are the ones that you want to target if you're a fighter. Not a handful of media, because everybody has social media. Take Tank, for example. He has over 7 million followers. That's more than any media outlet. Boxing or not boxing. That's pretty impressive. Ryan has 12 million followers on Instagram. But because of all the antics before the fight, a lot of people thought Ryan Garcia was not going to fight. I didn't think he should be fighting. And then he fought and won, and I was happy for him. But his antics, he was not faking, and that was not a drill. He was drinking, and he was doing stuff that fighters should not be doing. And it, once again, goes back to the point. Devin Haney can't beat Ryan Garcia, who didn't train. Ryan Garcia, who was just smoking, partying, the week of the fight, every night went out to a nightclub. I was getting calls from nightclubs in New York and pictures of Ryan Garcia partying his ass till 6 a.m. every night, fight week. And the week before the fight, he was in Vegas hanging out with some lady named Savannah. Not sure who she is, but she has her own fan base. And Oscar even said that when he came to New York, he got a call, hey, Ryan's hanging out with girls and partying. So no one knew that Ryan's going to make it. He didn't take it serious. And look what he did. Imagine if he was serious. Imagine if Ryan did train. Imagine if all that, if he was on point. Devin Haney now says, oh, I never want a rematch. I won't give him the rematch. And Ryan says, well, it's your loss. And Devin's going to have trouble. I think his problem right now is more probably mental than physical, because he probably never believed that he would lose, and he probably never believed that he would lose in this fashion. And remember, this is the guy that beat Kambosos twice, back to my point about Zepeda destroying Kambosos. And Oscar Duarte, one of the biggest stars at 140 that the world doesn't know yet, also trained by Robert Garcia, is on the card. So Jose Ramirez trained by Robert Garcia, Zurdo trained by Julian Chua, of course, and Zepeda with his team. So that's going to be in Saudi in November. It's going to be Mexico night in Riyadh. And Oscar's excited about the things he's doing, about the opportunities he's bringing. But it's going to be interesting to see how Haney was told by Eddie Hearn, you're not going to make that $50, $60, $80 million payday. And Eddie Hearn was right. And the sum that he told him that he would make, because they didn't take minimums. They relied 100% on pay-per-view. It's kind of like Kovalev did that with Ward. As amazing as a fighter that Ward was, he hasn't lost since he was 12. I don't think he ever lost in amateurs. I don't think he ever lost in a pros. He wasn't a pay-per-view star. Being a pay-per-view star is much more than just being a talented fighter, much more being than a Hall of Fame, much more than just being... You could be effective in the ring, but pay-per-view star is a whole nother ballgame. You have to have people love you. You have to have people willing to pay money to watch you. And I'm talking about average, not hardcore boxing fans, which is probably only 85,000, period. Hardcore, worldwide. I'm talking about people who love sports, who love fighting, but also love football, basketball, ping pong, tennis, and everything else, and tune in to sports. Canelo has that. Gervonta Davis has that. Pacquiao has that. Mayweather has that. Those are the core that have it. You may have one or two more on the border, but it's very hard to achieve that status. So there you have it. Stay tuned. But what do you think? Oscar De La Hoya, clap back. I like this new segment of his, and I think I could turn it into like a 20-minute show, and it would go crazy viral. Stay tuned. FegasNewsReporting.com. I'm Millie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.
Ellie Secback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
Both fighters went to the hospital.